This question and answer session. Shivam, sir, when will you teach Gauss, Stokes and Green's theorem? So today is the beginning of differential equation, that is max 2. So probably that is mostly the next week after multiple integrals, after differential equations, then I will start vector calculus. In that, the second part is called that Gauss, Stokes, Green's theorem. Next, the question from Madhur. Is truncation error formula for trapezoidal and Simpson's rule and also regular falsi method not in the syllabus? See, regular falsi method actually not mentioned in any stream. It is actually secant method is the modification of regular falsi method, not required. But truncation error trapezoidal rule, generally long back CS 2007 or 2009 the question asked. Actually, you know the errors in all the numerical methods, okay, that time we have discussed. But in a material or any textbook, if you refer, why we are getting approximately, that is exact, you can compare, that is the error. So truncation error means that is maximum error. So generally, error in trapezoidal rule is considered when the polynomial is taken by straight line. Okay. So whatever we are integrating, that fx is considered as a linear polynomial, then we get an error that et less than or equal to h square by 12 into b minus a into m2, where m2 is equal to maximum of f double dash x mod for all x belongs to closed interval a comma b. Similarly, error in Simpson's rule es is less than or equal to, truncation means is equal to maximum error, h power 4 by 180 into b minus a into m4, where m4 is equal to maximum value of mod f double fourth derivative x, f fourth derivative x for all x belongs to closed interval a comma b. Okay, you can easy to understand, but question related to that proofs, everything is very tough, enlarged, 3 pages, 2 pages also. But whenever the maximum error asked, you take instead of this is equal to. This is useful for actually finding number of subintervals n to reach that problem into accuracy. I told that meaning of accuracy, error, everything that time. Okay. So, the next one, Raju, why the third option is incorrect in linear non-homogeneous question? See, this is the third option. What is linear equation? Dependent variable and its derivatives occur in the first form, first degree only. Dependent variable and its derivatives must containing degree 1 only. So this is a dependent variable 1, dependent variable term. It is not having degree 1. So that's why this is a non-linear equation. Okay. Next, coming to this, this is also a non-linear equation. What is linear, non-linear? A dependent variable and its derivatives having degree 1, e power minus y containing a dependent variable. If you are expanding y square, just like Maclaurin series, Taylor series in max 1 calculus, what is e power minus y expansion? 1 plus y by 1 factorial, y square by 2 factorial, dependent variable has having degree more than 1. That's why this sine y, e power minus y, whenever the terms containing y, that some functions containing y, you see that is non-linear term only. So that's why this is option C, option D, non-linear equation. Okay, both are non-linear. Okay, that is. Next, Partha, sir, please explain. In the example of homogeneous and non-homogeneous, the option C, dy by dx plus xy is equal to e to the power minus y, and option D, dy by dx plus e to the power minus y equal to 0, are they linear, non-linear, homogeneous, non-homogeneous? Just now I told you can watch VOD, option C, option D, non-linear. Okay, and this is non-homogeneous and this is homogeneous. Okay, because this is a dependent variable term. Y, if you are go on expanding, 1 plus y square, y cube. So that's why this is homogeneous and this is non-homogeneous. But option C, option D are non-linear. Option A, option B are linear. The question related to linear equation and non-homogeneous. So option C, option D are non-linear. Regarding homogeneous, non-homogeneous, option C is non-homogeneous, option D is homogeneous. Next, option C, option D, both are non-linear. Option C is homogeneous because this is a dependent variable term, this is a dependent variable term, and this is also homogeneous. Option C, option D are homogeneous only. Next, Sneha, in last question, gate 2014, option C, dy by dx plus xy is equal to e to the power minus y is non-linear homogeneous equation, right? So, option C is non-linear homogeneous, correct. Next, Rahul. Last question, all options explained, repeat please sir. Option A is linear non-homogeneous. Option B, linear homogeneous. Option C, option D, both are non-linear. Option C, option D, both are homogeneous. Okay. Next, Shraddha. Sir, as you told that because of e to the power x dy by dx, degree cannot define. E to the power dy by dx. Okay, very good. Same as which more terms are there in which we will say that degree cannot be defined. Don't say it is more terms. As far as the degree definition, all the derivatives should be in polynomial form. What is polynomial form? The derivative should end somewhere. For example, e to the power dy by dx. If you are expanding by Maclaurin series, 1 plus dy by dx plus dy by dx whole square by 2 factor plus etc. So each is a dy by dx term. But it is never ends. It should somewhere ends. Then only it is called polynomial. What is polynomial? It is containing finite number of terms. E to the power dy by dx is an infinite series expansion. So that's why degree is not defined. Next, Manish. Integrate from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 sine 2x by 1 plus cos x. Now, it is according to properties of definite integrals, this Max 1 paper, calculus, whenever the limits minus a to a, look at the integrand, this is your fx, sine is odd function, so numerator is odd function, denominator, 1, constant is even function, cos term is even function, even plus even function, so denominator is even function, numerator odd function. Its product becomes, that is quotient or product having same properties. So finally this is odd function. Answer is, according to properties of definite integral, answer is 0. Next, the question from Sachin. In last question you solved, has asked for non-linear and homogeneous DE. But option A is linear and non-homogeneous. Sir, please repeat, I have not understood. The question related to linear non-homogeneous. Okay. You are telling linear and homogeneous. See, option A, according to linear, each term, that means the differential equation is called linear, a dependent variable and all its derivatives having degree 1, no two terms multiplied. That is dependent variable, derivatives should not multiply. So that's why this is linear equation. This is also linear equation. Option C, option D, both are non-linear equation. Coming to homogeneous, non-homogeneous, what is the definition? Every term, that is each term, must contain a dependent variable or its derivatives. Let us see option A, dependent variable, derivative. This e power minus x, it is an independent variable term, should not contain a dependent variable or derivatives. That's why option A is non-homogeneous. Similarly, you check as above, option B is homogeneous. Option C, option D also homogeneous. Next, the question from Madhur, what is the meaning of pivot in numerical methods? So, it is generally referred to diagonal elements. Okay, a11 into x plus a12 into y plus a13 into z. Consider any number of equations in unknowns. The diagonal elements a11, a22 or b22, a33. These are called pivot elements. For example, 3x minus y plus 2z is equal to 0. What is the pivot element? 3. It's the diagonal element. First diagonal element, second diagonal element that are called pivot element. Generally, they are considered as large compared to other elements in the same equations. Next, Shubham, dy by dx plus xy is equal to e to the power dy by dx. Is the equation homogeneous? Yes, because it's non-homogeneous. Why? e to the power dy by dx expansion is, according to Maclaurin series, 1 plus dy by dx, etc. Except one remaining, all containing a dependent variable derivatives. But one is a constant which is not containing a dependent variable, that is non-homogeneous. Next, Sjit, the accuracy of the Simpson's rule quadrature for a step size h. So, just 5 minutes back, I have explained, this is error in trapezoidal rule, Simpson's rule, that to find the number of subintervals, this is the accuracy formula, you can watch VBD. Next, Niraj, give one example, first order and degree with radicals. Dy by dx plus 1 whole to the power 1 by 3 is equal to dy by dx whole square. So, this is a polynomial, but 1 by 3 is not a polynomial, it is called radical. Cubing both sides, you asked according to first order, all the terms both sides I containing, I took first order only. Cubing both sides because cube roots. So, this 1 by 3 and cube cancelled. Now, the left side becomes dy by dx plus 1. Right side becomes already dy by dx having square and whole to the power 3. So, that right side becomes dy by dx whole to the power 6, a to the power m, whole to the power n is a to the power m into n. So, now this the last step is free of radicals and fractions as far as the derivatives. But first derivative is repeated. Highest derivative is first derivative. So, order is equal to 1. Here, the right side power 6, but the left side is power 1. So, which is the highest power 6? Once the order of the differential equation is found, its highest power is called degree. Okay. So, highest derivative is 1. It is repeated 2 times. In such cases, you consider highest degree. That is, 6 is the degree, order is equal to 1. Next, Umang, sine dy by dx is also considered as radical. Yes, sine is a function. The operating on dy by dx is considered as radical. Very good, Umang. Next, Ayer, is it necessary to make the differential equation free from radicals as you did in the first problem? Yes, without radicals and fractions, we cannot find the degree. Directly, we can find the order as 3 and degree as 1 is correct or not. See, that after squaring, square root eliminated, then only we got third derivative whole square. The third derivative is order is equal to 3, then its whole square is called highest power, that is degree is equal to 2. Next, Ashwini, sir, the first example that you have given for linear and non-linear differential equation, we can write the expression x into dy by dx minus 3y is equal to x square, as x square minus x dy by dx plus 3y, at that time the power will be 2. No, sir. See, what is the power? Dependent variable and derivatives only. You are considering as independent variable. X is independent. There I told y is dependent. Y power 1 and its derivative dy by dx having whole power 1. This degree order defined for dependent variable and derivatives only. Please take care about that definition, Sashwini. Next, Sahil. In the today's question of d square y by dx square is equal to e to the power dy by dx, degree should be 1. Because when we expand the exponential series, it will have only powers of dy by dx. But according to the definition of degree, it is the power of the highest order in the differential equation. Okay, you only saying highest order power. But what is the highest order in that example? My example, second derivative d square y by dx square. Okay, that is order 2. But I told it is free from radicals and fractions. Exponential is a radical quantity. How do you eliminate that exponential? How do you eliminate that exponential? If you are using Taylor series, Maclaurin series, you will get infinite terms containing dy by dx. So, you should contain finite number of terms containing dy by dx to find degree. That means, you should get polynomial form as far as the derivatives. Every derivative should containing the representation of polynomial. So, if you expand e to the power dy by dx, you will get endless terms, dy by dx whole power 100, etc. But what is the meaning of polynomial as far as the derivatives? It somewhere should end. So, finite number of terms contain dy by dx, then only degree is defined. So, now I am continuing the class. That is the fourth definition. We are now homogeneous, non-homogeneous, linear, non-linear over the related question for both definitions as above 3 and 4. I have provided and I explained clearly. Now, the next definition.